Hi everyone, it's Roseanne, and I'm bringing you my design team project for October for Dee's Elegant Embellishments Facebook store, Zibbit store. And I'm filming outside because I think the lighting in my craft room is not going to capture all the details very well. So what you're looking at is a mechanical heart. It's a steampunk project that I created with more of Dee's charms than her lace this time around. I do have another project that I did use quite a lot of lace. And in fact, if you've been watching my mini-series on the canvas box, that is my second design team project. It's a process video that I am going to make a final video and show you the box and explain the laces and the process that I did once the process video is done. Anyway, let me go ahead and get started with this project. Using my camera and trying to hold it, so I want to apologize up front for the shakiness. I started off with a piece of chipboard and cut it into a heart, as you can see there. And then I used my Martha Stewart glitter paint to just roughly paint it on the back, and then I put a piece of chipboard and some seam binding to act as the hanger so that this can be hung up. And then I used the heart as my base to create the mechanical lady, or the mechanical working heart. I haven't really given this a title yet. I'm toying between the name of the a woman's mechanical heart, or a lady's working heart. I'm not really sure. But anyway, here we go. I started off with the chipboard, as I said, and I don't know if you'll be able to see, which is why I'm filming outside. I did use some lace to cover the entire chipboard heart. Once I covered it, I went ahead and spray painted it with my glimmer sprays, and I started building with the gears here, which you probably can't see, but I made a layer of gears, and let me see if I can turn it over in the back again. Here you go, you can see some of the Tim Holtz gears that I also cut out of chipboard. I also used some of this, it's like a plastic mesh that I got from the Home Depot. And I, once I painted the gears and glued them in place, I went ahead and I started with adding the plastic piece here, and also use some gold paint, as you can see there, to distress not only the plastic mesh but also the I used some in places for the gears. I also used my Sharpie pencil, you can see on the edge there where I colored it in. I'm gonna go ahead and, obviously, I've layered everything, so I put some of this steel wool also that I purchased from Home Depot and just scrunched a big piece and kind of layered it throughout here. And once I had that in place, on top of all the gears, I just started building. So this piece here and this piece here and this piece here, which is the leg, all came from last year's steampunk, graphic 45 steampunk paper line. I don't have the new paper, the new graphic 45 steampunk line, so I used this one. I always wanted to make something steampunk, but it just hadn't gotten around to it, and I thought I would make this in the colors of my room so that I could go ahead and hang it up in my room. I know this probably isn't the typical colors of steampunk, but that's what I chose. Anyway, the laces that I did use were this gold lace, this little, let me get out of the light, black lace there. I used some more of the gold lace there. There's also some tinsel type gold lace here that I used. And let's see here. I believe this lace here was just a piece from my stash because it didn't have a wide enough piece to cover the entire heart. So I basically just started layering things and I wanted to use all of Dee's charms. So there is one of her charms, which is a light bulb, and what I did there was just painted it with some of the Martha Stewart paint there in the center. My friend Neri last year gave me some of the these clock pieces in a rack, and I have used it in my other kind of altered person project that I made last year, and I've used it again here for the gears in her hair. I coiled up some wire here, and this is a Tim Holtz light bulb. This down here, which I kind of covered, is a huge heart from Dee's store. It's her steampunk heart. And then that key there is also a charm from Dee's store. And that's just a piece of chipboard that I glued a image of a clock and then put my favorite little diamante from my gold chain that I love to use so much. I laid this light bulb on top with a clock charm from Dee's store. And, oh, let me go back up here. Right back there is a piece of junk jewelry that I received from my friend Janet. And right there is actually part of the shabby heart that Dee sells in her store also, with a feather behind it. And what I did is she sells them in white, but I love to dye things when I need them a certain color, so I think she sells them in white and cream. And also a pink. So what I did was I took the pink one and I glimmer sprayed it with red glimmer spray to match the project. And I just cut one of those little roses out and tucked it back in there. So even though you buy these hearts, you can cut them up and use them in different ways. You don't have to use them in the heart. Or in its current state. So I have another gear back there and the Roxy Berry here. This also is a beautiful charm from Dee's store here. There's a flower here that I glimmer sprayed to match the project, and this is another sort of trumpet. Let me see if I can turn towards the light so you can get a better look right there. This was a charm that Dee gave me for my birthday, so I used that. And this is her little hearts that I painted with gold paint. Those are some flowers that I got from my stash. And I just put diamantes, and this is some more of that bling mesh that I have that I like to play with. So this little piece here was this type of lace. And this was given to me also in my birthday package from D Store. This one is the black that I tucked up in here. This is the lace that I used for that. And then for here and here, and these flowers here and here, I used, move this out of the way, I used this gorgeous lace, and I cut the flowers out of here, and I used this part here for the trimming. And you'll see that in my process video once I get that uploaded also. Let me see. So, sorry if I'm shaky. This also is another piece from my stash. Some more of that plastic, I don't know what you call it, wrap. I guess it's in the plumbing section in Home Depot. And then these are all the bling pieces that I cut from the bling chain that I love so much. This is a music paper clip. And then there's another part of the clock parts. This is a paper clip here that I just glued this flower on top of. And there, as I said, is the little flower that I cut out of that gold trim. And I just put a bead on top there. This is a penny farthing charm from D Store. And, oh, this is just a fuse, a broken fuse. Let me see. This is the flower center from D Store. Gorgeous. This is also a charm from D Store. There's the bling chain that I love to use so much, and that's what I used to cut here. Only this was a silver one. There's the flower again that I cut from the gold trim. This is a steampunk heart that Dee sells in her store, and all I did was got a piece of bling from my stash and put it in there for a, instead of a cameo, because cameo isn't really fitting. This is the pearl flower center. This is also another piece from the design paper, and that is a Tim Holtz light. This is Dee's hand, beautiful hand charm here with another piece of diamante there. And this is just a piece of zipper that I cut and stuck in there. I took the hand underneath it so it looks like you're unzipping. The zipper in her hand is coming out. This is also a butterfly from Dee's gorgeous charm collection. And I think that pretty much covers all of the charms that I used from her store. So I'm just gonna turn this over and give you one more quick look at everything that I did here. I'm sorry for the lighting. My doggies in the background are coughing, sneezing. But I hope you like what I came up with, Dee. I had a lot of fun making this for my room. I've always wanted to make a steampunk project, and all of your lovely charms really helped in creating this project. I really didn't have any hardware prior to you giving me all of these charms. So for that, I thank you. And I hope that everyone goes by and stops and visits Dee's store and picks up some of these really gorgeous charms for themselves. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. As always, I will have the links to Dee's channel and Dee's store once she opens up. Her store is not quite open yet. But you can always send Dee an email at her YouTube inbox and, you know, ask her whatever questions you have, or maybe catch up with her on Facebook as well. So for now, everyone, this is my design team project, my first design team project for Dee's Elegant Embellishment store. I hope you like it, and thanks everyone for watching, and thank you again, Dee, for all this yummy goodness that you've sent me to play with. I had the best time, and God bless everyone. Bye.